Maybe I'd be happy to let it all go and dedicate my life to making jelly molds. Learn to cook and learn to sew. I'm a happy homemaker.
Hi, and welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy, and I'm your host, and I am coming to you from another summer's day in Toronto. Last week, it felt like winter. This week, we're back to summer. This weather is all over the place, and I'm sure I'm going to get sick at some point because it's just up and down and up and down, and oh, Toronto weather. Weather around the world, crazy. Anyway, it is a glorious day outside, and I am happy to be visiting with you today. I have a few things to share with you, not a lot, but a couple of things to share, some yarn. I did get a lovely package this week as well, and so it'll be a bit of a Comfy Red Couch light episode this week, but after the past few episodes, which have been well over an hour, I'm kind of glad to get back to a shorter episode. If you would like to find me, I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. And I'm not as active on Instagram, I guess, as I would like, but I try to post at least once, maybe twice a week. And Ravelry, these days I'm keeping my project pages up to date, but all of the chatter threads, I'm not as visible in there as I'd like, but it's a very busy time right now, and I'm hoping once we sort of slide a little bit more into fall and things get a little bit calmer that I'll be back to sharing a little bit more on Ravelry, maybe also on Instagram, but we shall see. If you are new to the Comfy Red Couch, welcome. This is a podcast about knitting, sometimes some other crafting as well. And I'm always glad to have anyone who would like to visit the Comfy Red Couch. There's lots of space on the couch. And if you are a returning viewer, you know I love having you here every week. And I know you have your requisite cup of whatever it is you're drinking. You've grabbed your spot on the couch. You've got your project of choice. And you are ready to come and join me for some chatter about what knitting I've gotten up to this week. So welcome, and let's start off with some tea time. And today I am drinking out of my fun little mallard duck mug. Two different mallards, and then on the inside, just in there, there is a little duck as well. And this is a, and I always forget, I have to look underneath. Oh my gosh, Royal Worcester. Royal Worcester mug. I love my little mugs, but I always forget who makes them. I don't know why. It is Royal Worcester, and these are Rendale designs. There's lots of little animals that they do, and I just love these mugs. They're just a small little size, but they're so, so fun. Inside there is another duck and a nice way to enjoy a cup of tea. Today I am drinking another loose bag that I have, and this is a Bird and Blend that was sent as a loose tea bag with my order, and this is the digester. So this has pu'er tea, it has some ginger in it, it has some orange peel, ginseng, and fennel. So I like orange peel a lot, I like citrus a lot. I'm not a huge fan of ginger or fennel, so I'm not sure what I'm going to think, but I wanted to try this one, so we'll see if this is something I order or not. But anyway, let us say cheers. I hope that you have had a fabulous week, and I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead. So cheers again. You can never say cheers too many times. It's not terrible. I can see where it would be soothing on your stomach. Is it one I would order? I'm not sure. Maybe? Probably not, though. But anyway, nice to have a chance to try the digester. So, oh, nice warm in my tummy, too. The past week has been super busy, as it always is for everybody I know, and the projects that I've been working on have been all relatively hush-hush, and I won't be able to share the actual projects with you, but this week I get to share a lot of yarn with you, so I'm very, very excited about that. And let us start off with my princess bag, and this was a project that I took with me to Florida when we went to Disney World a couple of weeks ago. I started it a few days before we left and did a little bit of work down there. And I am now finished the project inside this bag. I believe it's going to be released sometime this upcoming week, or if not this upcoming week, shortly thereafter. So the yarn that I have to share is, I love it. It was perfect for this project. And this is Iced Cinnamon Stars. And this is a Little Tailoress yarn, or when I purchased it, it was Little Tailoress. Now the yarn company has been renamed Dandelion and Dogwood. And this is Amy of Little Tailoress. This is her yarn. And I bought it just before Christmas last year. I loved the colorway. I think she also had it on Sparkle, but I didn't get the Sparkle base. And for this project, I'm actually really glad I just had the regular Merino Nylon blend. So I cannot wait to share with you what this has knit up, because it is glorious. When I saw the pictures for the project that I used this yarn for, I knew immediately this was the yarn I wanted to use. And in fact, the name of this yarn also goes really nicely with the name of the pattern. So keep your eye out. I will post on Ravelry and link to the project once it's released. And I will probably also post on Instagram once the pattern is released, because I just can't wait to share. So this is Iced Cinnamon Stars, Little Tailoress / Dandelion and Dogwood. And oh, I loved working with this yarn. So that is the project that was living in the princess bag. And this project has now been blocked. I've taken a few photographs. I need to take a couple more photographs, I think, but this one is done off the needles and just waiting to be released out into the world. I'm very, very excited about that. The next project that I'm going to talk about, and I'm really excited to share this with you, is Nancy Drew. And again, I'm not able to share what the project is, but I am able to let Nancy share with you what yarn she has been hiding in her lovely little bag. And this is a bird leg bags. I love my bird leg bags. I think I said last week, I let you know that you could buy them at simplysocks.com or simplysockyarn.com. Before I let that out into the world, I kind of went over to simplysockyarn.com and may have bought some more bird leg bags, because Vicky from Bird Leg Bags is no longer going to be making bags. Inside my Nancy Drew bag is this fun little print. And I also get to share the yarn that has been hiding in here. And this is a gorgeous yarn by Tracy of Nora George Yarns. This is Macaron. And this skein of Macaron came with a mini, and this beautiful soft, soft pink is also being used in this project in a very interesting way, I think, for part of the project. And I'm really loving how these two have knit up together. And I think for the project that it has made, it's been perfect. So I'm halfway done this project and I still have some to go. I probably won't get back to it until early October because I do have a few other things that need to go on and come off the needles, but this macaron and mini are what have been hiding, or some of what have been hiding. Of course, the project you can't see in Nancy Drew. So that is what one of her little secrets is. So, but Nancy Drew, she has lots and lots of secrets. And yesterday saw me casting on a brand new project. And I have put that brand new project in my To Kill a Mockingbird bag. And this bag is from Little Skein and the Big Wool. I bought this back in the spring, I think it was. Maybe I bought it in the fall. I have a feeling it was the spring. It has a fun handle on it. And in fact, I have two To Kill a Mockingbird bags with these handles. And my princess bag, when I went to Florida, I grabbed the handle off of the other Mockingbird bag that I have because I wanted a handle. So very, very versatile, those handles on the Little Skein and the Big Wool bags. So this has been housing a brand new Shawl Society project. And the Shawl Society Season 3, Shawl 5, is going to be released this Thursday. So I had originally thought this was a pattern that was going to be released the last Thursday of the month, as the other patterns have been. But this one is going to be released Thursday, and I'm not sure I'm going to have it off the needles by Thursday. My plan, though, is to definitely have it off the needles and blocked by the time I film next week's podcast, and I'm excited to share it with you. Now, Helen has shared her yarn for the Shawl Society 5, and she has used a Baron Sheep's clothing as the yarn, and there is a singles, a very light fingering weight or heavy lace weight singles that she's used along with a mohair. And when I originally saw the pictures for this pattern, I had a gorgeous skein of Hedgerow Yarns as a mohair that I had bought, and I shared it on the podcast and I said I know exactly what I would like to use this for, and I really, really wanted to use it for this project. But the yarn that I wanted to work it with, I'm not sure had enough yardage, so I did not want to play yarn chicken, so I have changed my yarn completely. So I'm not going to be using a fingering weight and a mohair at all. What I am using is Tussa silk lace. So I know I will definitely have enough yarn. And I am using this gorgeous purple. This is called Rotten Blueberry Ice Cream. And this is by Dye for Yarns. And it is a Tussa silk lace. And Dye for Yarn, this is their logo. And as I said, this is Rotten Blueberry Vanilla Ice Cream. And this is 100% Tussa silk, and it is a lace. So it's a very, very strong yarn. You couldn't break it very easily. You need scissors for it. And yes, this is my main color that I'm using, and I'm really liking what I've paired it with. I am using a second color as well, and for that one, I am using Ghost, which is an undyed Tussa silk. So I'm using this color as my second color. So these two together. And as I said, this Shawl Society pattern is going to be released this Thursday. I'm just at the 20% mark. I started yesterday. As I said, I probably won't have it off the needles Thursday. It's always a possibility, but not guaranteeing, but I will definitely show it to you next week on the podcast because I'm so excited. And this one is going to be a gift. I've been wanting to knit something in Tussa silk lace for someone who is allergic to wool for quite some time. And after deciding not to use the mohair along with the other yarn that I was wanting to use, I thought this will be the perfect project for my silk lace, and finally I'll get the gift that I've been wanting to knit up, and I think it'll be really, really pretty. So that is what is currently being focused on my needles. So, and as I said, it is hiding in my To Kill a Mockingbird bag. So these are the three projects I've been working on my favorite things this week. And other than that, I have nothing else to share on my favorite things. I did mention at the top of the podcast that this was going to be a Comfy Red Couch Light episode. And now that we are in brown paper packages, I don't have a lot to share, but I do want to talk about something I was introduced to in the summer, and I'm actually wearing one right now, and that is a NexCare Band-Aid. And my aunt this summer gave me a couple of these because I had, from all the sock knitting I had been doing, I had a hiya poke hole in my index finger, and those really, really hurt. And I had had moleskin, which is what I used to put on my finger here when I would accidentally poke a hole in my finger with the hiya-hiyas, because they are sharp and they really do cause injury. So she gave me one of these NexCare bandages, and I do have a box, but I think I took it to Florida with me, and I think it's still upstairs, but it has multiple sizes in it, and there's a little tiny one that just fits perfectly on your finger, wraps around a little bit, and it was amazing because it's waterproof, and it's probably one of the best Band-Aids I've ever used. And I tend not to like to use Band-Aids when I'm knitting, but this one is actually pretty good. So, and it's better than moleskin because the moleskin would fray. So, as I said, NexCare. And that, where a bit of shiny is the NexCare Band-Aid I am using. And the reason I've put it here, especially when I'm working with Tussa silk lace, is because I have a bit of a yarn burn line from all the knitting that I do. And so I just sort of put it on when my finger was getting a little bit sore from the Tussa silk, because it does sort of cut in a little bit when you've been knitting a lot. And this sort of helps alleviate the pain that sort of happens when you've got yarn burn across your fingers. So yeah, it's see-through, except of course this padded part, and the padded part is soft enough. As I said, the hiya-hiya pokes don't go through it, and it is super waterproof. I've got it wrapped all the way around. So this was the bigger size, and the smaller size that are in the box go perfectly here. So there will be days that I have them on both fingers, but definitely this is now my go-to for knitting injury protection. So yeah, that's something I wanted to share with you. And it doesn't, they're just really good. It doesn't catch on things. It is a little bit, I don't want to say tacky, because it's not tacky as in sticky from like gummy sticky, but it does have, I mean, you can feel that it's there. So anyway, if you have access to that type of Band-Aid and you tend to get hiya-hiya holes, really a good product to use. So anyway, that is going to be now my go-to. And as I said, I have a whole box upstairs. I've got to bring them down for when I get back to lots of serious hiya-hiya knitting protection. Okay, it is time to get to what is in my basket this week. And as I said, there's not a lot. I did get a lovely package from Tracy of Nora George Yarns this week. And in fact, this one was ordered quite a while back. So both Tracy and I were surprised that it took as long as it did. And Tracy threw in a lovely little goodie for me with this package. She went to a lovely store with one of her friends in the summer, and while she was in the Harry Potter store, she bought me a Slytherin pin, because Slytherin is my house, so it was nice to know that she was thinking of me while she was out and about. So I have a fun Slytherin pin to put on either this bag, or last week I shared some of my other fringe bags. I think this will go on one of the other fringe bags, maybe the green one where I'm going to put my needles. So that was one of the fun things. And another beautiful skein that I received, because we are now in the full-on yarn section, is this The Leaves That Fall skein. And it's just beautiful, soft colors. Even though it sort of got the autumnal name, it's really springy to me. And if you've tuned in before, you know exactly why I purchased this yarn. Two words, pink, green. And on that nice, gorgeous, natural base, a beautiful, beautiful yarn. So look at those gorgeous, gorgeous speckles. So this is The Leaves That Fall, and this is on MCM sock. So super, super squishy, soft, lovely, lovely, lovely. Now, and the funny thing is, when this update went up, I was thinking she was going to put it like in a couple of days, and I realized after the fact that in fact it was already live and I was very late to the party. Luckily, when I got to the party, there was yarn left, because there was a skein of yarn that I really, really wanted. And when I saw the pictures that Tracy had put up of the yarn, I sent her a direct message on Instagram and I said, there is only one name for that yarn, and it is Make My Heart Sing. And Tracy didn't name it Make My Heart Sing, but she named it something equally as wonderful, Heart Song. So I like to think that I had a very strong impact in naming this gorgeous skein of yarn Heart Song, because this really made my heart sing. And again, this is on MCN sock, because I was there a little bit late to the party, and of course all of the Super Sock, which is my favorite base of Tracy's, was gone. So I was able to get this, and I have to say, it is glorious. And after pink and green, there's something about a beautiful blue with sort of these speckles in it that just seems to capture my heart. So because these are both MCN bases, I'm not sure whether I will use them together or what I will do, but they are so soft and so beautiful. And this was my only package this week, and it was definitely enough to not only make my heart sing, but to make wings flutter and all of that. So, gorgeous, gorgeous yarn. And as I said, comfy red couch light means we're already at an empty basket. Look at that gorgeous, gorgeous yarn. As I mentioned at the top of the podcast, it really is a comfy red couch light episode this week. I mean, we flew through brown paper packages. We also flew through my favorite things. And now we are at Bits and Bobs. And Bits and Bobs is my segment where I talk about anything and everything not necessarily knitting related. And I think basically there have been two things going on in my life the past little while. That has been work and knitting. I am really hoping that next week I will have two finished objects that I will be able to share with you, both of them test knits. So crossing fingers that A, the pattern that was in the princess bag is going to be released this week. I'm hoping, hoping, hoping. If it's not, it will probably be the week after. And of course, crossing fingers that I am able to get my Shawl Society 5 off the needles and blocked by next Sunday when I podcast next. So I'm hopeful. Anyway, so I'm really looking forward to spending some time with my knitting this week and having some lovely projects to share with you next week. Other things that have been going on, Isaac finally got into the dance course that he had been on the wait list for at school. So on Friday, he sent me a text saying, I got into the dance class. So he has vocal music, drama, dance, and aquatics this semester. So just an amazing semester at school. And then next semester, he has his two musical theaters, he has his English class, and he has his history. He also takes a course called Repertoire, which is an after-school and weekend course. So he is super, super busy, but he's doing the things he loves, and that is important. Nathaniel seems to be adjusting to grade four really well, and he is enjoying his time. I had a chat with his teacher the other day, and I think it's a really fantastic match. Greg is also back to work after a lovely little bit of time off during the summer for his holidays. And in addition to work, he is back taking a Latin course at the university. So he goes a couple of days a week for his course, and he's enjoying being in the class again. He says there's a lot of people that took it last year that are back in the course. And he is also looking forward to doing another zoo run. So last year he did a 5K zoo run, and he's been training for another one this year. So that's going to be next Saturday. So his zoo run, his Latin course, and of course he's back to work. So it is back to full crazy around here. Both Tasha and Scout are doing well. I think Scout has finally adjusted to her haircut. She hasn't come to visit us on the comfy red couch lately. She's just over on the other couch there having a good sleep. It always seems to me that September is a crazy busy month. And just before I went back from holidays, I was thinking to myself how September and January, those 2 months, I don't know why, they always seem like they are both 2 months long. And looking at July and August as a collective, you've got 62 days there, they seem to pass in about 2 weeks. So I'm not quite sure how that equalizes out into the grand scale of the year, but it doesn't seem fair that September feels like a 2 month long month, but we are halfway through September and I'm hoping that things start to calm down soon. But otherwise, it is a busy, busy September, but the beautiful weather is back. I think I can handle that. Anyway, I think that's all I've got to share on Bits and Bobs this week. And as I said, it's going to be a very short episode, which is probably fantastic for me because it means less editing and more knitting for a beautiful Sunday afternoon. Thank you so much for joining me on the Comfy Red Couch this week. I am so glad to be back to routine, and even though this is a much shorter episode than the past few have been, I'm hoping to get it back to, you know, a nice length. So I always like about 40 minutes seems to be a good length for a podcast, but sometimes they're shorter, sometimes they're longer. Each week varies. Anyway, I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead filled with lots of relaxation, nitty goodness, and lots of time to sit down with your beverage of choice and knit on your project of choice. Have a wonderful week, and I will see you next week when I hope to share two more projects with you on the Comfy Red Couch. Bye. Heart song were to be put into musical notes, I wonder what that would sound like. I think something absolutely beautiful.